usual place. They would have seen this. Mysterious. Fascinating figure. Gazing west to the sunset. So ancestors and the structures. The vast, the monumental, the gargantuan. The absolutely, mystifyingly large structures of the pyramids, temples, and various other architectures they developed over the course of thousands of years. All right, let's continue on to the journey. Lost in the pagan non-Christian cults were banned. That's why we're here. We're here to find out as much as we can. The area of ancient Egypt had been inhabited from the prehistoric period in the post-glacial era. Eventually, if you do that math, two to it's like kind of the, we're in some vague prehistoric state, disbanded tribes, warring neighbors, and minor nations, and then this man, Meanies, traditionally unified the northern and southern areas of the Nile, creating one vast empire along this magnificently historically important river. And I'm rambling on way too much and not showing you enough pictures, but I'm just so jazzed about this book. Yes, I just said jazzed, because you were wondering. was at the top of the hierarchical pyramid, with the sacerdotal class-wielding great political power, a step lower. Heard, let's see. Sophistication of the incorporation of this bird behind the brain of this pharaoh. His brain was, I guess it doesn't say who it is, but the exact figure is talked about for 64 BC. That central power was reinforced at the expense of the sacerdotal class. The capital was moved and what began. I really wanted to touch upon the African origins, the African involvement. Not involvement, but the integration of the integral role that darker, more currently, as we would think of them, Africans had in this burgeoning civilization. I've watched a few documentaries, and I think it's possibly very not brought to the light enough that this, after all, is, in fact, Africa. And it's on the cusp of what we think of as Arabic, Arabian, Saudi Arabian, Middle Eastern ethnicities. I don't know, as a very ignorant person on ethnic, on different cultures, even on my own, admittedly, I am far from pronouncing authority in this, but I also am one to love, enjoy speculation for the sake of understanding reality as it actually happened in history. Disposed to believe, based on some of the evidence I've seen, that ancient Egyptians were in fact much more black looking, more African looking, than the modern day images might presume. I know there's plenty of illustrations that show them looking a little lighter, but you can't escape the traditionally black features, such as broad stress the evolution. The evolution and sophistication. Yet, at the same time, well, let's find out, but I have a feeling that the original Pyramid of Giza, the most revered and impressive architecturally pyramid was built before this pyramid, this era, and I don't think was ever matched again. So it's like there is a refinement in culture, and perhaps a lessening of impetus to create grand structures like that. Slave labor and resources to build something that grand since then, but I think overall there was an evolution towards an increased level of sophistication in literature, metallurgy, architecture, and jewelry, and overall culture. Since applied sciences also found fertile terrain in the Middle Kingdom. Specialists, medical, mathematical, and veterinary treatises were written. You can only imagine how many cats were saved due to that revelation, the innovation in medical technology. The construction of pyramids were revived, albeit on a smaller scale. The Louvre, while the largest temple of all time, mentioned by Herodotus in Book 2 of his history as the Labyrinth, was also built. So there you go. They shifted their perspective from large to more elaborate. This next part I was reading earlier, and actually I made a video earlier, but I scrapped it because it was hopefully worse than this one, but it was the context in which the Semitic or Jewish or Hyksos, meaning heads of foreign countries, you always hear that. What you always hear is that the Jews were enslaved by the Egyptians, and Moses, their savior, their prophet, their leader, their king, was able to free them and lead them to the promised land, almost, after 40 years of wandering in the Sinai desert. So, and yeah, just on this channel, because I'm talking about seemingly controversial stuff, such as people with a darker skin tone than me, people with a different religious background than I, although not very different. I don't want to get it twisted that I am although I can't imagine anyone who has watched even one of my other videos would ever think I'm racist or religiously intolerant, specifically anti-Jewish or anti-Semitic, perhaps even anti-Hyksos. So, no, I hope you guys recognize that I am purely was a period of transition called the Second Intermediate Period that perhaps as a result of the weakness of the pharaohs of the 13th and 14th dynasties saw the gradual infiltration of the Nile Delta by nomads. This is fascinating that the Hyksos actually dominated Egypt for 250 years and spanned the 15th, 16th, and 17th dynasties, which saw numerous successive pharaohs, of whom only a few names and rare works are known. So interesting, you know, like, I just wish, I feel like I'm never being told the whole story, so, I get so jazzed when I, when I learn this history, it's so cool. So, the Second Intermediate Period concluded around 1550 BC. Accession of Amos the First, the progenitor of the 18th dynasty, during which Egypt was finally freed from foreign domination. In this period now, the so-called New Kingdom saw great monarchs. These are, of course, the famous ones we always hear about, or at least I do. Which is precisely who these sea peoples actually are or where they come from. Another fascinating mystery, but so we have, let's see, the 19th dynasty with the reigns of the great pharaohs who left testimony to their power in the form of monumental works. Seti the First, Ramses the Second, and Merneptah. The period also saw the war with the Hittites and the Battle of Kadesh, as well as the biblical exodus of the Jews under the leadership of Moses. So, that's apparently 1000 BC. And the Hyksos, the old ancient Jews, were dominating in, let's see, roughly 700 years before. So, if you can imagine, for 250 years, Jews were dominating Egyptian culture. And no doubt there was a lot of fusion and assimilation of Egyptian and Jewish elements into both religions. We all know how much religion can change over the course of even a few years. So, you can only imagine after 700 years, 250 of which the Jews, the Hyksos, the Semites dominated, then were finally overthrown as all rules tend to be. And that leaves us with roughly 450 years where I'm sure the remaining Jews were, of course, enslaved. And until Moses was their mole, he was their inside man, and he was able to lead a mass exodus, bit of biblical proportions nonetheless. You can imagine I just raised my eyebrows there. Yeah, so it's cool to get the whole context of it all, I think. Hope you guys like it too. Alright. Well, you know what? It's getting late, and this was way, way longer than I intended it to be. Although I love giving you guys long, very long episodes, it just takes so much effort, and I have very little time. Fascination and love of history and science and past and future speculation with the Kardashev scale and the Fermi paradox that you guys love. And I also love, actually have a couple things, ideas I'm working on for you guys, which hopefully are a little less rambly and more right to the point. Carl Jung's he tries to ground the origin of our consciousness, very much incorporating Egyptian mythology. In a successive series of waves, because they always come in sets, don't they? At least as a surfer, I can attest to that in my little area of experience. But damn, I just love, fascinated by the potential understanding, you know, one potential theory backed by loads of evidence of our emergence. Slow, of course, but nonetheless, I don't know, so powerfully amazing emergence and transition from animal to man and ape to man, more succinctly. I don't know, you can imagine, like, just imagine all the history, all the, just in the last, those 700 years where the Jews came in, conquered many parts of Egypt, ruled for almost 300 years, were overthrown, kicked out, the remnants were enslaved, then they were led by this massive, today we still know it, the Exodus, by Moses, a prophet, a great leader. He had to have been, and that was only like 700, 800 years, you know, maybe 1,000. And just think of how many dramatic, courageous, just seriously monumentally heroic events, wars, phenomenon, adventures, journeys, spiritual awakenings, vast cultural sublimations, really, and rapid technological advancements must have occurred in waves of a couple hundreds of years or thousands of years over this 100,000-year period leading up to us finally being able to stop being nomadic and settle.